As we are moving further towards the final, let's focus a little bit more back on the teams who are fighting here in the final. So we have Pontgard versus Eden. Let's see, the players are starting to load in, so probably we will start very shortly. 30 seconds might be actually correct. We are waiting for 3 more players to join the lobby. And guys, remember the tournament, these are no bad teams here. All of the teams that participated are pretty much the one of the best teams on the servers, or at least like top 10, top 5, right? They have a lot of achievements behind their back in terms of territory war. They have a lot of achievements in terms of ranked battles, and definitely this is something to keep in mind. So this is very, very highly skilled players we are talking about here. Let me modify my camera a little bit because I see it's not reacting too well to the white background. Or actually I don't need to, because we are almost ready to start the game. Few highlights before we go into the game for the teams. For the Eden team, Bladeshift player who I talked through, the highest level, one of the highest ranked, 2600 ranked across the Eden team, and he actually has the most average troops killed across the all the battles, all the seasons, 109. He's definitely performing very, very well. We are jumping slowly into the game. I believe I have already changed the teams. Indeed, I did. So we can move to the game screen. Seems like not too many changes in terms of the weapons so far. So we will see in a moment if maybe some last second changes will be done. But yeah, we still have 30 seconds, so let me tell you about Pontgards a little more. So they are Wolf Syndicate House from North American East server. They have mixed USA Canada players, and they are part of the Kingdom Alliance. Heavenly Kingdom Alliance, right? They are having a lot of good results on Territory Wars. The past 3 seasons, they had held the Conqueror City and Reginopolis, and currently they hold Turulvaros and Algolia. So that's a definitely good achievements on their end. Additionally, Kai the God, good player across the board. He presented a lot of good things. He has 2500 level on his main account, and he has the most average troops killed from his whole team. 125 troops killed across all the, you know, battles and all his account history. When it comes to the hero kills on the Pontgard team, we have Ripcats, who is having around 10 average hero kills per game across all the sieges, fields and so on. So definitely standing out. For the Eden team, this is Viriato with 5.1. We are into the game, so let's focus up. We have Eden defending, and we have Pontgard who is attacking. On the weapons choices, seems like Eden is similarly playing with two light armors, short bow and dual blade, and 4 spears, 1 musket, so 5 medium armors, 7 medium and light armors on the 8 heavy armors on Eden team. On the other end, most of the players on Pontgard have heavy armor, and there are just 3 muskets and 1 spear, so only 4 players with medium armor. Definitely a different approach on the units here. Shout out to Flag D. But right now let's focus on the game. First game won by Eden. So if they win this one in the attack, they are winning the whole tournament. If not, we are in the game for the final in the next one. The resolution will be there. Seems like the standard tactic is being executed on both ends. Defending team, blocking the entrance, shooting artillery, ensuring that their units are not losing. Look at that, this is interesting. Rattans, crossbows, with the fire upgrades. So this unit is called Rattan Marksman, if I recall correctly. Yes, Rattan Marksman. Double Rattan Marksman with fire upgrade, destroying very heavily the towers. And this is something that we might actually see first in last time, because I don't think we have seen such a use of the Rattans earlier. Look at that. I'm sure they have damaged a little bit the tower earlier with the Kulvenis and so on. The Rattans just finish it off, but the tower is not there. So far, as we've seen, teams pushing up the walls use the center tower 99% of the time. Like, except like two attacks which were through the gate and like some forces coming from the left side over there, almost everything was moving through the medium tower. But right now it's gone. It has to be pushed once more. I see you on the chat, guys, highlighting that some trebuchet also hit the tower. So also, yes, seems like attackers have hit their own tower, working against themselves. But Rattans definitely helped a lot. We will see if this will be the result once more. Look at that. Double Rattans, very nicely played by Payan, the team leader of Fondgard. Damage buff increase. The unit is glowing red because Glaive player can increase the damage of the unit, and they are shooting at this tower with damage increased. But Trebuchet is here and most of them will die. If they would be moved away, if Fondgard team would have moved them away, I believe that there is very high chance that this tower wouldn't be allowed to enter anymore, that it would be destroyed once more. But very nice reaction on Enden. They seen what happening, they know what happened, so they reacted. And they reacted very fast. Very well placed, with very well played Trebuchet, clearing the special tactic that was prepared by the defenders here. The tower indeed very heavily damaged, very close of going down, but will be mounted. And that's what Eden wanted. That's why they waited for, and this is their go signal. Guys, tower is here, push, we don't have too much time. 7 minutes have passed. Remember that this tower was destroyed earlier close to the wall, so it had to ride two times very long time, and maybe this will be the key for the victory of the defenders. So now, very nice, very nice. Look at that. Watch out for the trebuchet, but the Fondgard team very aggressive in their defense, very aggressively pushing away. And this is something that they need to watch out. In these pushes, you are very open to the trebuchet. And let's see if Eden will use it. Indeed, they sent some of the forces to B point to grab the attention of the defenders, but main force is preparing on the attack over here. And one thing to notice, because of the double Rattan, they don't have Namcans anymore. So constant pressure from the defenders cannot be put on the Eden team. The Namcans are not bleeding out enemies. The Eden team can walk around pretty much uncontested where they want. And this is their decision if they want to attack A, B, retreat, heal. This is on their end to decide what they want to do. So far it seems that with this moving around, they lost quite a few units and quite a few players. So they are right now waiting for the back tower to happen. So right now we can see utilization of the top tower, which is over here, and some people are moving in behind, and push is here. Eden is pushing from both ends. They're using their advantage, their numbers advantage they had here. They are using it nicely. Most of the defenders are cleared through. But let's see. Will Fondgard will just give up? Will they try to recontest? So far, more pikes are coming in. More spikes are pushing. They are cleaning the point, and Eden have a very nice defensive position. Few players have died. Key units like Forte Braccios are retreating, and this is very unfortunate for the defenders. It seems like Fondgard will not be able to contest and retake this point. So this is very well executed. Two sides attacking, nicely one point. The key entry to this point was definitely over aggressiveness of the Fondgard. Aggressiveness is good, but not if you lose a lot of your units to the trebuchet. And this is something what happened here, and this allowed the pawn guard, this allowed the Eden team to push through the 8 point. For now, pawn guard, the defenders are heavily resupplying. So you can see no one of them is on the map. They are retreating all their units, preparing their final defense, and seems like we will see the final defense on the point here. Please remember that Eden point have won already the first round. This is best of three. If Eden will be able to achieve the victory once more, they are going to walk away from the tournament with the first place. So this is key what they will do right now. And they are preparing. They are preparing the push on the behind. Look at that. A lot of cavalry is coming in the behind. Unfortunately, the presence of the pawn guard is very small. They have just one unit of fight here. These are vertebrates. They are very sluggish, so they cannot react to flanks. And this is what's happening. The flanks are happening. Eden team is flanking from all the directions. Three cavalry units, three different angles, covering all the forces. But reaction is there. Pawn guard, they are coming back. Imperial pikes were key to stop this initial pressure, but the trebuchet, once more the pawn guard, the trebuchet is their doom. Look at that. How many units have died on the pawn guard side with the trebuchet? The Aiden team, they have trebuchets on point. They have allowed them to capture the A point easily, and right now the push on this plus is looking very, very good for the Eden team, thanks to the amazing trebuchet they did. So this is here right now how it looks. Seems like it's not going to be over yet, though, for the pawn guard. Look at that. They are still contesting the point. We have two short swords running their heavy survival build, probably full armor, contesting the point. This means that the attackers from Eden cannot capture it. They cannot resupply. They are slowly bleeding out. This is crucial. If they will not be able to capture this point on the Eden side, their whole flank will be lost, and they will have to refresh and retreat and refresh their approach. But this cavalry movement, look at that, walking around the pikes and climbing, just flowing through the archers, through the backline. This was a key move. The arquebusers also here, most of them died, just four left, I believe. Few pikes left, and it's not looking good for the defenders. Seems like they lost control. The last units of pawn guard are here, coming out of the spawn. You can see pike militia is fighting. It's a not good a sign. If you can see on the top point, only 6 players are alive from pawn guard and 14 players alive from the Eden. When it comes to units, almost 800 units left for Eden team and 500 only for pawn guard. So this is very, very big advantage. The horse usage, not so good. They have rushed pretty much. Most of them died to the braced units. What they should have done? Flank more. Try to attack from multiple angles. And what's happening here is just a distraction, because the whole thing, the most important one, is happening up here. The Eden team, they have felt secure enough to just transition fully to the main cap, clean out all the defenders, and look at that. Simple capture, not allowing the pawn guard to even touch the main point. And we have 2-0 victory from the Eden. Congratulations to the both teams. Most definitely the both fights we've seen in the final were the most aggressive, the most rotational, the most tactical, and quite amazing, to be honest. So very well done for the both teams. Pawn guard taking the second place, still nothing to be ashamed of. I think it's very nice result, to be honest, especially considering that all the teams that were participating in the tournament today, they are top of their servers. They have achieved many things on territory wars, many things on the front of ranked battles, and other achievements. They played in many different tournaments as well, so a lot of experience going in. So no easy task to win something like that, and no easy task to even climb to the top three. So congratulations to the pawn guard for the second place, and congratulations for the Eden team on achieving the first place. Let's quickly do the post-game analysis. We need to drop to the winning team of Eden to talk with them on the interview in a moment. And after the interviews will be done, we will be dropping to the betting contest. So I will be looking at, we will be making a lottery and seeing who predicted that Eden will win. And out of these players, we will be choosing the winners. So for the boss battle analysis, key highlights for the Eden team, 6 kills on Oh Hydra. Very, very high healing. Killing machine, you could say, about there at this point across the whole tournament. A lot of kills for the unit. 3 players across over 100. Lucas Trell 113, the highest participation on the flag capture. Very, very high on all the players. On the defender side for the pawn guard, there you can see 3 kills on Onomi. This is the player that also achieved quite a lot of kills previously. And we can see that for the units, Torgadon very, very shining across other team members, 120 kills compared to the next person with 68. So outstanding performance from Torgadon. For the post-battle analysis, as you can see, we moved inside. The key highlight at the beginning is that nothing is really happening for quite a lot of time because Eden team had to move the middle tower they wanted to use the most twice. The first one was destroyed, so this was very good work from Pond Guard. I was quite amazed by the usage of Rattan Marksman with the buff, damage buff from the Glaive player, and this allowed them to destroy the tower. Moving on, they pushed inside, they tried to go to the B, but they faked it because the defenders, Pond Guard, have heavily tried to counter push them in the behind. The Pond Guard moved out of the A point, and they have give me a second. And they have lost a lot of players because of that, unfortunately, due to the trebuchet. So you can see these trebuchet losses here. This bubble is a lot of trebuchet losses on the Pond Guard side. Then the Eden team, they have counter rotated, so they moved back from the B team. The B point, and they have used the bottom tower to also flank the enemies, pushed from the both sides, they captured A. Then they have moved through plus point very fast, captured B very fast, so nothing is really happening here. Except of course the fight on the point, which I talked about a moment ago, and they have prepared for the final push. The tactic they have used was something we've seen early on in the tournament. Eden, they have used every force they had to push from behind. Unfortunately, Pond Guard had very small presence. Only one pike unit was there to cover it initially. And this was for the Bratches. They are very sluggish, very slow. They were not able to rotate fast enough and stop the charges. Imperial Pike Guards were coming in, but we know Imperial Pikes are very slow. They were not able to get there in time. So the Eden team was able to get through. And they contested the main point and finished.
Okay. Just give us a second. I'll do you see the EG channel?
We are going to interview in a moment with the representative of the Eden team, the winners. And in the meantime, let me go there behind. Okay. Okay, so we are
5 users and then I move. Okay,
how much time?
No, if you want.
Yeah, I'm ready. Okay, so we are going to move to
so
hello,
thank you for participating, and it was a very great round. Like
thank you.
Yeah, it was very good play from you. We didn't expect it to see that.
These are the representatives of the Eden.
I think, we gathered up some of the best players from our house in the team. And we really wanted to fight against the DNA guys because, you know, we see them in sieges around and we know that they're very good. So, yeah, we just spent a bit of time making like a strat on how to push this map and how to defend it. And it turns out that it worked. So it was pretty fun.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. So for my side, it was pretty interesting to see that you were the first team who actually defended the map. Like, yeah. The first three matches always winning team loses, and then you came and just do it like, yeah, it's no problem to defend this map.
Well, we knew that obviously DTI is a very strong team. Like, we are both from EU West 1, so we've seen what they accomplished and we know how strong they are. So we were like, okay, why not? Let's just go out with Cav. What's the worst that can happen? And it turned out that it worked, so it was pretty fun.
Yeah.
Combo?
Yeah, so congratulations, guys, on the victory. A lot of people were watching and were amazing by your performance across the tournament. So congratulations one more time. What I wanted to ask you about is something that actually amazed a few of us in the final when you were on the defense. The strategy with the double Rattan marksman and Glaive player making them strengthen their damage. Who came up with this idea and did you expect it? Did you test it?
It was the enemy team. Yeah, not us. Yeah. We were attacking on that strat.
Yeah, sorry, okay. So but actually this was so amazing, I wanted to ask you as well from the other perspective. Like, did you expect something like that?
I mean, we've seen it before, but in Siege, but I didn't think that they would do it in a tournament. Okay, so straight away, as soon as the first tower destroyed, we knew. I was looking at the units, I saw three units of Rattan Marksman out, so all of us would just call in, climb the towers, just treb them. Because they die instantly, one treb, because they're so squishy. So as soon as they were down and the tower is up, we lost about a minute, I think, in time, but it didn't stop us from pushing.
I think it's kind of risky having like this kind of strat, because after the tower, like three Rattan Marksmen, they don't really bring you any like kill potential in the fight, in my opinion. I'd rather have, I don't know, Namkans, for example, which we used, because the bleed stacks are a lot more effective. But obviously, it was surprising for them to use it, but it's very, I think, simple to adjust to once you see it happen.
Yeah, and actually what we mentioned, the lack of Namkan was visible as well. It's clearly seen that they replaced Namkans, because when you were walking around the wall from B to A and back and so on, Namkans were not present and couldn't, you know, put the pressure on, which was there for other fights.
Yes, on the fight when they attacked, I think I had around 70 unit kills with my Namkans. Like, it's one of the best units on that map, because you have like 360 view, so you fire on them everywhere they are, and it's free damage. Like, they can't really counter it unless they focus me with their muskets or longbows.
Yep. So.
Okay. Cool. Thanks. Another question I had is in regards to the rules. So how did you enjoy the rules with free lives, no artillery, and no golden era?
To be honest, it's pretty fun. I enjoy the gameplay without golden era. It feels a bit more balanced. I am glad we participated on a fair map, because I was hearing rumors about Valley Fortress and like Allenberg, which in my opinion, and in many players' opinions, are some of the most defended, defense-sided maps in the whole game. So I'm glad we chose Korak, and I think, from my perspective, it's a pretty balanced map.
Yeah. I mean, I super like the no artillery rule, obviously, because artillery is just mega OP in this game, even with the nerf. But the tier 4 was super fun, because obviously it's not like Hussar spam, Liao's Rangers, and everything going around and just wiping, so it's a lot more balanced and I think a lot more skill based with just
and also the no crafting rule, pretty good. We did a tournament before where we could craft and stuff, and I think that unless you wanted to spend 6-7 hours crafting, you know, it would have been harder for some people to be on the same level, whereas now with the no crafting, everyone had the same leadership and everyone had the same potential to kill and take damage, so it was pretty fun.
All right. Amazing. So yeah, watching this and a lot of players watching had the similar feelings, like writing right now that the rules brought the memories of, you know, closed beta and old times with small units, etc. Right? Now it's different on the live server. The last question I had for you is the defense. What were your thinking? Because you are the pretty much the one of the only teams, one of the two only teams that won the defense. So how did you prepare? What were your strategy into that? Did you got caught off guard on something? Well, amazed you from the pond guards team?
We knew that we couldn't fight on the walls because you get damaged by traps, obviously, and it's very open, and you get damaged by like javs and other ranged classes. So we just thought that if we kept like two players on A, if they were like depending on where they were pushing, if we kept some players on A and rotated all the rest to us and focused on holding them and flanking them at the same time, there was no way they could have pushed us. So we focused on basically getting the flank right and using the cav advantage that we have inside the city. That's pretty much it, I think.
I mean, also on defense, like, Jab Sergeants just, they're crazy. The amount of killing potential they have for the defense against the NA team, where Jabs alone had like 101 unit kills or something, it's just, with the resupply so close to A, it's a very, very good unit to be using, and only 230 leadership at Mega OP, I think.
Okay, sure. Thanks.
All right.
Any questions from the viewers, guys? You want me to ask something?
Some final words. I'm very glad that you participated. It was very fun to see your strategies, and in my opinion, the one of the best plays was your just Amiga lands. Let's go outside move. It was
pretty fun. It was pretty fun.
And also very rewarding, right?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, it was. Something that we always wanted to try, and I think trying it against a very good team, it makes it even more fun, in my opinion.
Nice. I really liked it. I'm just pretty happy how this tournament went on. Like, I'm very, very.
It was great. It was good. Great rules, great organization. I really liked it.
Cool.
So,
anything you would like to tell to viewers or other participants as a closing remarks on your end?
Well, make sure to not spam Liao's Rangers in Siege, please, guys. And Army Goods, please, just chill.
KOP.
Yes.
As always.
That's one of the reasons why I banned T5. Like, I knew that we would see them 10 times Liao Rangers or 10 times Wings of SARS. I already saw that coming, so better ban them.
Yeah. One more thing, please. Justice for heretics. Everyone needs to know this. Justice for heretics. It's some EU1 drama, but it is what it is. But a great tournament. I really enjoyed it, and I hope we can take part in some other tournaments that content creators organize. I might be organizing one soon as well. I just didn't have the willpower to do it, but after this one, I think I'm gonna get on that grind.
All right. There is one question I have from the chat, targeted at you, Ghostex. So people would like to know if you are free. I mean, not, you know, you don't have anyone in your life, and if you could share your phone number.
Oh, yes. for sure. Just PM me.
Okay.
Cool. Very nice. Okay. So, when nothing else is to say, I would gladly thank you all for taking the time also to talk with us. And I thank you for having fun at the tournament.
Thank you, boys. Yeah. Thank you for the organization and the opportunity.
Thanks.
All right, then it's time to say bye-bye, I think. All right.
As I said,
thank you, everyone, and I'll see you next time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Right. So thank you, Ari, as well for the organization of all of this. The best tournament I was in. Everything was flawless. No issues. Even, you know, when your PC tried to be against you, it worked well. So.
Yeah, but you see, like, I turned on the camera and it went like, what the hell? Everything froze, and I was like,
you
okay,
had your
bye.
Stream open in the background, and it's like, what?
It was pretty doomed. But yeah, I also thank you for the cast, for the English cast. Yeah, I hope you had fun casting the tournament. I definitely had. And yeah, some last words for the German viewers.
Most definitely. No, I don't know German, so I will not butcher your language. But yeah, thanks all for watching and amazing stuff. So, GG.
All right, we'll hear from you, Tadra Combo, and have a good evening.
Have a good evening, guys. Bye bye. All right, guys. Thank you very much for participating in the tournament and watching. And try.